Welcome. In this video, we're taking a look at how you can create your first Mentimeter presentation. Perhaps you've seen Mentimeter in use, or maybe even voted on a Mentimeter presentation as an audience member. But in this video, we're taking a look at it from the presenter's point of view. I'll be giving you a step-by-step guide on how to get started. Let's dive in. So here I am, logged into my account, and I'm going to go ahead here and click New Menti. This will now open up a new presentation. Let's start from scratch. Here we can see all the various slide types that are available in Mentimeter. And we're going to start with the classic, the word cloud. This allows you to ask a question and the audience can submit words that'll show up in a cloud. So let's start with an easy one. So I have my word cloud question there, and then I'm going to click on the word cloud and decide the number of responses. Here, I just want one each. Let's do another slide. So go back here to new slide. And this time, I'm going to use the multiple choice. Multiple choice is a great way to poll your audience by giving them a few options. So here I'll ask, what department are you in? And then I can choose my options. Here, you can also change the visualization if you want. Maybe we'll do a pie chart. And then finally, I'm going to add one more question, an open-ended. The open-ended allows your audience to submit longer answers and thus give you more information as a presenter. So here I might ask, what initiatives do you have planned for the fall? And here I'm actually going to allow multiple responses per person since I want to hear all the initiatives. All right, now I have three slides. I'm going to go quickly just to themes, just to change the background of the presentation. And let's go with maybe the true blue. I like that one. And now I'm ready to present to my audience. A quick tip though, in order to preview the presentation, you can click on this little eye icon. This will then show both the presenter screen on the left, as well as the voting screen, which is what your audience will see. And here I could put in a word and hit submit to test things out. You can also show test responses here to see what your slides will look like once you get real votes. There we have our Menti presentation. And once I'm ready to present, I'm going to go up here on the top right corner and click present. Now this takes it to full screen, and this is what you will be showing your audience once you're ready to go live. Now to join the presentation, the audience can use the code up top that is randomly generated, or my favorite way to join, by using the QR code. So here I'm going to press I to show the QR code, and then your audience will simply be able to scan this QR code and they can start responding to your questions. As you can see, the slides will follow, so your audience is always on the latest question in their phones as well. Once you've collected responses in your Menti presentation, you can go out of present mode in order to access the results. Here I have an example from a meeting earlier this summer, the marketing meeting at Menti. And as we can see here, I can click on the results tab to view all of the slides and all of the responses that I have received. I can also see participation and also download the results if I would like to. That's it for today, folks. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to see more tips and tricks with Mentimeter, and I'll see you soon.